Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm explaining some of the concepts, those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview, like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. In the last video of this interview concept series, I have explained the difference between observable and subject. If you have not seen that video yet, please see that before this video. I have provided the link in the description. In this video, I'm going to explain the differences between subject, replay subject, and behavior subject. For that, I have created an Angular application in which I have two buttons, one to start emitting the data and other to get the data. And I'm using ng4 to show all the data we received after we subscribe. In the app component TS, initially I have created an empty array and a subject. In the emit data function, I'm emitting some data every 3 seconds. And in get data function, I'm subscribing to get the data. And I'm pushing the data received to the array I created initially. So if I click the emit data button and then the subscribe button, we can see we are receiving the data. But why we have not received the first data? The reason is, when we click the emit data button, the first data has emitted immediately before we subscribe. So we lost that data. If I put some console logs, we can understand. Now, if I click, we can see the first data has been emitted and now only we are subscribing. So we will receive the data starting from 2 only. Let me show it again. Now 1 has emitted, 2 has emitted, and 3 has emitted. Now I am subscribing. So we will receive only 4 and 5. Also, if I click subscribe one more time, we didn't get any data because all the data has already emitted. This is how subject works. Let's change this subject to replay subject. Now if I click, we can see the first data has been emitted, 2 has also been emitted, 3 has also been emitted. If I subscribe now, we got all the previous data, and then 4 and 5. If I subscribe one more time, we again get a new set of data. That means replay subject keep the previously emitted values in memory. Also in replay subject, we can specify how many values we need to keep in memory. Let me mention it as 2. Now let's see. When I click, we can see 1 is emitted, 2 is emitted, and 3 is emitted. If I subscribe now, we can see we didn't get 1, but we got 2 and 3 because we have mentioned to remember the last 2 emitted values. Now all the data has been emitted. If I subscribe now, we can see we are receiving the last 2 emitted values, 4 and 5. This is how replay subject works. What is behavior subject? Behavior subject works similar to replay subject, but it always keeps the last 1 emitted value. Also using behavior subject, we can initialize the first value to be emitted. Let me show. Here, let me change it to behavior subject and pass it as null because I don't want to initialize anything now. So if I click, we can see 1, 2, and 3. If I subscribe now, we can see 3 and then 4 and 5. As 5 is the last emitted value now, if we subscribe again, we will get 5. If I pass some value instead of null, behavior subject will consider that value as the last emitted value for now. So if I comment the first value, which gets emitted immediately, and if I click now and immediately click subscribe before it start emitting the first value, we can see the value we initialized is emitted as the first value. And then it continues 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let us also see another scenario. Now I'm going to subscribe after 2 is emitted. So now we can see we got 2 only, not the value we initialized. Because once behavior subject receives a new value, it overrides the last value, even if it is the defaulted value we specify. This is how behavior subject works. So I believe you got a clarity on subject, replay subject, and behavior subject. Hope you liked this video. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.